E pā e tō mātai matua nui te rangi, te iawi atua nui. Tū a uri, whā iyo, e whai atu nā, kia tatau tiaki, kia tatau mana ki kau atua nō rā I a mātau I ngā wā katoa. I roto I te kokoni, I roto I te wā pū anō. Kua huari ti te tīmatari a mai o ngā kōrero ki Hawaikirangi ki roto ki tēnei rā tēnei o ngā pare ārau. Te rua te kau mā whitu o te marama lima. Kua tae tonu a ke mai. Tinana atu a hau a Kaea Matiaha te aroha tai te rangi pū a tāta. Ki te kawe ake, iaua kōrero ki te kawe ake. I te titiro tonu anō ki te pūoro ki ingi mangu a me tātahu pasi e whai atu nei I roto tonu anō hoki I a koe. A I roto anō hoki I a koe I roto I ngā tū a huatanga I a te karaiti. Me tā hakuna ake noho atu ki tō utika I roto I aia. Kia whakamoe mititia rā koe kā tika. Kia whakamoe mititia kia whakanuia. Ko koe I anō tēnei e whakaaro nui nei anō hoki kia mātau. A puta atu anō kia mātau I roto I te tahu. Mā kā kanui matua I roto I te tai hawauru au kati kia mātau. Tēnei ake anō mātau te kai whiu, te pou whiu atu I ngā mea katoa. Tēnei ake anō mātau te pou whakarahirahi. I ngā mea katoa I roto I te tū ākana, I roto I te ariki mataura, I roto I te ariki ure tārewa. I a tahu mā kāka nui matua ure tārewa hapū nui tonu I roto tonu anō hoki I a koe. E tō mātai matua nui te rangi e, e pā te iawi atu ai. Kia whakanui a rā koe, ko koe I anō e whakarahirahi kau atu anana anō hoki. Ko koe I anō e whai atu anana. Kia tino, tutuki pai tonu, ki roto ki a mātau, a mātau e whāi ngā tuna. I roto I te pēne, I roto anō I te titiro. Ki te tino tāonga nei, meki te tino tāonga nei, tāonga tuku iho mai rā nō, I roto I a rātau tāonga tuku iho mai anō, I roto I o mātau nā whanaunga, I roto I ngā hapū ki hūrara, I roto katoa nō, I o mātau whanaunga I roto Āwhirika I a Hawaii ki Matua, e kōrero hi ake ana e tahu mā kā kanui, Matua I roto I e nei rā tonu anō hoki. Whakamoe miti ake. Ko ia tēnei te whakaaro hinengaro o hoku ki atu ki tēnei wā. Kia whakamoe miti tia koe kā tika. Kia whakanui a kia anō a ko koe kā tika. Te ia we atu a ko koe anō. Kā hore, kāre mea, kāore he mea itu atu I tērā I a mātau. He nui anō no tou ārohanoa, he nui anō no tou atawhai he whakaaro atawhai he ngākau atawhai anō nōhu I ngā wā katoa. Noho tonu atu ai ki a mātau. Ahakoa rā te keke, ahakoa rā te tūhaka, ahakoa rā I a mātau anō. Te pakanga nei ki ngā tū āhuatanga e noho rawa atu ana nā e kokoe I ngā wā katoa. Epa, te iawe atua, ko tēnei rā haiu, ka whakamoe mititia, ā kokoe ka whakamoe mititia, ka whakanuia. Ai te ingoa te iehua. Āmene, kā piti hono ka tātai hono, ko te mate ki te mate, te ora ki te ora, kā piti hono ka tātai hono. Tātau mā no tērā e tātau, tātau kā toa, ka hurike ake mai nā, ki otu ki ngā kōrero Hawaikirangi, tēnā nau mai haere, tēnā hukihuki ake mai. Tēnā tātau, tēnā rā tātau. Māori ora. Tātou mā, tātou waiata, whakawhana ke atu I ngā kōreo I roto I tēnei rā tonu nei. Mehe mea I tino pai kea keai I tērā wiki. A mehe mea korera nei, kua hoki ke atu anō rā tātou mā tau te kōreo atu I ngā puoro. A te kīngi, koe anā te whanake hi aroha mai. Koe te āhua kua tatapau taku hau e... Whawhai haere atu ana e ahau tēnei rā, tata ki tēnei rā katoa. Ana ka ahua reiti anō hoki ahau. I roto I tēnei rā te nui anō ngā āhuatanga kāwanatanga o roto I te tarati. Nā rira he hui nunui kua haere. He āhuatanga mea hai mea I roto anō hoki tēnei rā me taku whāwhaiwhai haere I roto I ngā tū āhuatanga katoa tata ki te rā katoa. Anā, katahi anō ka tīmata reiti I roto I tēnei rā I a Hawaikirangi. Hoi anō, haere tonu ai ngā kōrero, me o tērā wiki I raru ai. Kare anō au I tino māra mā tuai. Kā reau i tū whirawhira tuai e tahi arake ara tuku. Karakau au i tērā wiki. Hoi anō i raru ke te tēpū. Te mea pāho i roto i te taupuni i tērā wiki. Nā reira te tīmata hiāti o ngā kōrero i a rōpata i te kīngi. O te pōro kīngi mangu. Ākua mate, kua tino ora kē mai. Mai nā ngā huatanga i te kīngi. Anakai te kī a tonu ko te kīngi tonu aia i roto i tēnei rā tonu ne anō. Ai. Ai, no reira, ai. Hoi anō, kā tika huki kia aia, kia whakanuia. I te mea nara, tōna kawe atu i te pūoro nana, he tino kaitua pia i tērā kupu i te ātāhua me tērā whakaaro. Kaitua pia i te ātāhua i te mea nana, tōna, hea tērā, te pā ona, te pā, te whakariteri te mai i taua pā, i roto i ngā wahanga katoa ki ana waiata katoa, i roto tonu anō hoki i te waiata kotahi. Nā, pērā rawa tonu anō ōna i roto i te pūoro. Nā reira, hoi anō, te mea nui kia whakahoki hoki mai rā hawi ngā kōrero i ngā huatanga hai kōrero atu ki roto ki tēnei rā tonu nei. Ki e rā kōrero tērā wiki, kua āhua ngaro i roto i tēnei wā. I te mea nahoki ka rānguna e āhau te whakarongotanga tērā mea hopu ki atuai o te kōrero o ngā pāhotanga i te pāhotanga kotahi. Arai, podcast, ana, rāngona atuai āhau te raru katoa o te tatakite katoa o te kaitua i te haurua mai o te āhua ki ngā whakarongotanga i roto i te takoto mai o Hawaikirangi i tērā wiki. Nā reira kua tatararu katoa, e rā, kai reira ētahi pūoro ke katoa kare no āhau i tino māra mātua i pēwhea i takoto pērā i hoi anō. Kua mōhio ke te pōu whakahaere, nā reira i tika mai ai ki roto ki tēnei wā, kai te kite atu āhau me te rāngona atu, āhua raru atu āhua nō hoki i tērā wiki. I kore ai āhau i tino mātau rawa hoi i rāngona atu ai me taku whai atu kia kokoti atu ai. Auareake i tērā wiki hoi anō. Me taku pōhehe i roto i ētahi wā kua kokoti ake. Hoi anō, anō hoki taku kōrero auareake. E tātou mā nau mai haere. Ki tēnei wā kai te waru mēniti ki te whā. I roto i tēnei o ngā rā tata paiu atu te maramarima e tātou mā. Kai te pau haere tēnei tau me tō tātou mātau anō whai atu ki tērā haurua o te tau. Kā re tino roa atu tērā me tō tātou ihihi haere i te nui o ngā tūāhuatanga kai te haere i roto i e nīrā. Te kotahi mai o ngā hapū re tārewa me ngā uri i roto Wairarapa ki tararua o te mataua Māui, ātai atu tonu hoki ki a here tau ngā rarau te wairua, here tau ngā rarau te wairua. Ai, mātau katoa, te kaumārua i roto Wairarapa ki tararua o te mataua Māui, te waru o roto katoa no i a here tau ngā rarau me te wairua. Tino mea nunui ki tēra, tino nui. Kai tō tātou wā ki te ono mēniti ki te whā, me tō tātou tautoko atu e Tūtahu Trust Tahu Investments Limited, tō mātou pūtea moni tautoko. Ai te pāhoatira, tātou mātau I ēnei kōrero I roto I a Arrow FM 92.7. Tai atu anō rā hoki ki te taetanu hoki o tātou mātau e whaitanu atu ana ki te mātakitaki mai I ngā kōrero me ngā ahiwatanga o roto I te taupuni pāho I a Hawaikirangi e whai atu ana kia pāho atu ai. Kia whakaata Wairarapa e tātou mā. Tēnā nau mai haere, coming in from the cold, tērā o ana waiata a te kīngi. Nā rere kā nui atu anō hoki ngā kōrero. Kia tātou mātou e pātu ana ki tēnei o ngā puoro. Me aku tuhi tane anō tērā wiki anō o tērā wiki anō I Waimarie I tuhi tane atu anō ai. I whakarite ke atu ai I āhau te hōtaka I tērā wiki. Nō katai ake mai āhau. Nō katai ake mai. Tīni haere e āhau, ana, katahi ka mutu atua I roto I te, ka paupea te hāwhe o te hōtaka I tērā wiki, kua tino pauke taku whakari te haere. Hoi anō, I roto I tēnei rā, kua huki mai anō āhau me aua tanea, ki te whakatituki pai mai anō ai, I tēnei o ngā kōrero I tērā wiki, ka ngaro atua I te nuinga e tatau mā. Kai te mihi atu, kai te mihi atu. Me tō tātou titiro atu ki Ārōpata, ā te kīngi. Ai, you know what? There's so much we can say about the music of Bob Marley, who has been the reggae king undisputed for so long now. And many say he's going to continue to be. His music is just the most fabulous of reggae music that anyone has ever heard. And people like me that have grown up playing the music and listening to Rōpata all the time can vouch for that. The most wonderful reggae music that... that we have ever heard. So I just while I'm getting the next video ready, I just wanted to chime in there in saying that one of the reasons we decided to bring in the examination or the titiro of Bob Marley's work is because we came across that waiata by Tūtahi, the particular rendition of Get Up, Stand Up, the cover there, and we were particularly critical of it. And so what we decided to do was, because of our comments of how to, I mean, one of the comments were to whenever you do a cover of reggae music, you must enhance that cover. Now, one person said to me that's why we had the show last week and we brought the examination of Bob's music in early in the show. We were going to do other things in this part of the show, but we decided on the examination of Bob's music, he titiro, ki tā te kīngi, tā Rōpata. And they said, well, how? They said to me, how? How do we, you know, the music of the king, how do we enhance that? Any of his songs? You know, that was a really good question. I said, oh, good question. You know what my answer was? My answer was very, very carefully. Very, very carefully. Well, you know, it didn't actually match the question. But after I explained just a tick later, I said to that person, I said, and then if you follow the other directions of our judgment on Tūtahi, you'd do fairly well to enhance his music. And we said to put yourself in to the song, take ownership of the song, keep basically your major feel in there. Well, there's a major reason in most reggae songs. Most of them are done in a certain way because of the deep meaningfulness of the lyrics, the meanings and the message that they carry. Reggae is messenger music. Reggae, apart from being rebel music and apart from being music that is indeed a weapon of the Lord, a weapon of God, and something that fights down the evils of the world. Reggae music is a music that what you'll find if you take hold of it and you make yourself that music. That's basically what I said to this person: make it you, make the song you. Take over the music and become reggae, you know, which is a huge ask for anybody. Only then would you be able to enhance any waiata of the king, of Lord Bata. And so they said, oh, right, okay. So we can't go wrong, you reckon? And I said, you shouldn't go wrong. You shouldn't go wrong. If you follow those directions, you should be all good. And I mean that, and I meant that from the bottom of my heart. Played Bob's music for so, so long now. His music I've never stopped playing. I can remember doing recordings of my own versions of some of Bob's songs way back at the age of between 8 and 10. Songs like Stir It Up and Baby Baby We've Got a Date and Stop That Train, Lively Up Yourself. I can remember all those times just basically living in the music and living in the time. Those were the times when Bob really was starting to really rocked the world. He was a rock icon by that time, and so I was loving it. Yeah, and so yeah, look, and you've got to enhance it, and that's the best way to do it, is to do it with you. Put yourself into it. Do it and do the song in a way that it almost reinvent the song. You know, that's what I said to that person. And then straight away we thought, hey, should we bring the examination of Bob's work in early? And straight away everyone went, wow, why not, you know? Because it would really just add to the basic fact that what we were wanting to do with the critique on Tūtahi was to show a bit more of what not to do. And just like I tried to show with the trying to play those renditions of Bob's songs as the only person independently playing core reggae in the studio. And it just doesn't work, eh? It doesn't work. It doesn't matter how hard you try to do that, you'll never get it 100%. So that's the risky part of it. And I was all nerve-wracked right through that. So, just a few examples there, and I was ghastly. A lot of people didn't think I was. They thought I was pretty good. I said, oh, well, that all right for you guys, because you guys don't have to, you know, take hold of that rich artistry that goes into the song and look to cover it as best as you can and get every touch right and every movement right and all that sort of thing. I said, you don't have to do that. And when you're trying to play it in the studio and you get almost half or even in one of those songs, I got three quarters of the song absolutely ghastly wrong. And although they didn't notice it, they didn't realise that. So, and I said, yeah, that weighs heavily on you. It takes its toll on you. So I wouldn't try that at home. Definitely don't try that at home, tatauma, because, it can destroy, especially as a musician, it can destroy your confidence. If you keep trying to do that, you're always going to fail. So it's fail, 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 fail. The more you try and play core reggae in the studio on your own. And, I had three pretty good goes, but I failed miserably, really. And then I got it 70% better the following week when I tried it again with a bit of practice. I had had a bit of practice then. Woo! And so here we are, e tatauma. And just a little bit about Tsutahi's rendition of Get Up, Stand Up. They didn't take into consideration as well that song Get Up, Stand Up is about a meal ticket. And apparently Rasta in Jamaica only have one right, and that is the right to a meal ticket. Imagine that. Living in a country, living in the ghetto areas of that country, and that being your only right. You wouldn't want to miss it, eh? You wouldn't want to miss it. So Bob resounded that particular fact. You know, if, you know, treat it like your only right. Every right you have, treat it like your only right. So Tsutahi missed the point. Although they had a good feel there. I like that feel. It was real, you know, it was a real mission feel. You know, they had a real mission going on there to protest, which was sort of, you know, not quite halfway there. Not quite halfway there, although it was a really good feel. But when you get a feel for what the real deep meaning of that song is, what the meaning is behind the words in that song, you start to realise it's a lot more than that. And, you know, you've got to treat it like it's your only right. And you've definitely got to get up. You know, no time for a tau. Like I said in my judgments, I said, hey, well, what's with the tauira at the beginning? You know, it's not worth it. Not worth it. You know, there's going to be so many different people lining up with their meal tickets or lining up to get their meal tickets. Mate, you got no time to do anything. You're going to have to already have done your tau, done your inoi, and whatever else you need to do way before that time. But as soon as the time comes to get your meal ticket, you're up there. Okay? And you don't want to be last, because as the old saying goes, if you're not fast, you're last. Okay? And get up. You know, Bob says all those things. You know? And imagine that. That being your only right. And then you being an inhabitant of the ghetto of that country. Etama. It's no wonder Bob wrote this next song and performed this next song. But even the depths of this next song, by Nōpata, the in-depth feeling with this song is yet a more spiritual one and a more Rasta foundation is inlaid into that deep meaning of this next waiata. Anira, e whaiakini, e tatau mā, te kīngi. Rastaman Live Up. Live at the, I believe, 1971 Reggae Sunsplash, 1979 Reggae Sunsplash, e tatau mā. Kai te whitu mai I te whā, kai te rāngono mai rā e tatau ngā kōrero I a Hawaikirangi. A kāia. Matiaha te arohata I te rangipū a tātā, e kawai ake nei ngā kōrero nā. Kahuri! Rastaman liver. You see, David slew Goliath. tāhua rawa. Rastaman live up tira. E tātou mā me. E tahi o ngā ahiwatanga o te kawena. I aro pata I te kīngi. I te pūoro nā. Tēnā o ngā pūoro. E kōrero kaua kia nā I roto Hawaikirangi. Te pūoro kīngi mangu ara. Ia reggae. Music of the Black Kings. Koe anā tā mātau I taua pūoro. A me tō mātau whakawhanaunga hi atu. Kinoto o ngā tāngata o roto I taua pūoro rā. I ngā hapū ki hūrara. Tai atu anō rā hoki ki a Awherika. Kinoto o Aperitinia. Kinoto anō hoki ki Etiopia ki a Ehipa. E rā o ngā nana, ngā tauiwi o roto Awherika, o roto Hawaii ki Matua e kōrero hi a kia nā I mua tonu I hona. A e tātou mā a, kanui ke ake ngā puoro mai I te kīngi Kaea Matiaha nei. Kaea Matiaha nā e haere ana I rā. Hoi anō, yeah, let me get back to some of the things. Aroha mai, kai te kai tonu a hau taku kai I roto I tēnei ahiahi. I roto I aku whāwhai haere, nā, e kawai haere a kia nā no rā hoki I a hau taku kai. So, yeah, haven't had much time to stop and eat. Have had to do lots of talking and directing and guiding in today's work in today's governance environment of Tūtahu Trust Tahu Investments Limited. Mai I roto I te runanga nui o Tahu. And Tahu Hapu Nui Tonu Incorporated. Yeah, e tātou mā. During this time of examining, ka titiro atu rā e mātau te takoto a te kīngi I tēnei pūoro. You know, we will examine the way of the king with reggae music. E tātou mā, like no other. And all reggae musicians are like that. When you play reggae, you play it like no other. But Bob epitomises that, doesn't he? He is the one in a million. The only person that we find, I roto Tūtahu Trust Tahu Investments Limited, that really comes closest to epitomising that same epitome of the king's carriage of that music, of reggae music, is his son Ziggy. So, yeah. So beautiful to listen to. We love, you know, most of Ziggy will chop and change now and again. He'll sort of vary his style a bit, but now and again you get a lot of the touches of the king in Ziggy's music, so if you listen hard to that. Another thing that I wanted to say is that within this segment, within these parts of where we, I think we're going to go on Bob's music for the next couple of months. So during that time, and we'll have Pōkō that'll come in during that time, we'll get some of Bob's songs being played by me, and some of Bob's songs also being played, and some reggae by me and some of the people of Tahu Posse. E tātou mā. Yeah, so you'll get some of the some of the outcomes of our examination of Bob's music and the way that we've been able to be privileged to utilize Bob's music and his ability to carry the music in the way that he did. Looking at also the simple fact that Bob was, you know, the king, you know, and you could tell. I've even been through every heavyweight in reggae music and listened to all their music and gone backwards and forwards from them to Bob, from them to Bob, from them to Bob. And he keeps topping everybody. And even today, you know what? We've got heavyweights, new heavyweights today, a lot of modern takes on reggae music, different, you know, different colours and shades coming in there in reggae music, and he's still topping the pops. And his message of Rastafari keeps topping the pops too. A lot of people don't want to admit that. You know, a lot of people thought, Rastafari started to go out, you know, in terms of being something that people love to follow and be a part of. That's not true. Rastafari is still very much alive. In fact, far more alive today than it was in Bob's day. So, yeah, just in case people are getting the wrong idea there. Being a Christian, you know, I'm not afraid to, you know, I've still got lots of relatives, lots of friends that are Rasta, you know. The fact that I went Christian, which was it wasn't fully calculated or premeditated at all. But I was having thoughts of joining the Christian faith. There was just something about it. In fact, I've always had lots of Christian friends, lots and lots of them, lots of Christian friends. And, I just felt cheeky sometimes, because, you know, I was always hanging about with them. I was always getting great, you know, great friendship and real family-like relationships we were developing all the time. And yet I'd never join them, You know, that was like the cheekiest part of it. I'd never join them, never be a part of them. And yet I used to get all this goodness from them, all the goodness of God through them. I used to rack it in, you know. Well, now I'm a part of them, and I just think one of the main things one of the main things that drove me to Christianity was the ability to be able to fellowship more. I wasn't able to do that with my Rasta friends. We weren't able to fellowship all the time, though I got to. And even though I was jamming the music just about every week, and still, you know, my workload never gave me time to do much in the music industry. So I used to pull the odd gig and do the odd jam here and there, and sometimes even fundraise for different causes and also causes under our trust. So I ended up doing tons of that, and all my spare time got taken up by fundraising. And you know what? Yeah, you guessed it. I was playing reggae music all the time, and so that's sort of what my life revolved around before I started to make time out of my busy schedule in iwi development or hapu development. To be able to do a bit more work and then take my music into the industry. Mind you, I've pretty much always been a part of the industry, because even during that time I was still knocking about with guys like Manny Abraham, Hareruia and all those guys sometimes, Brannigan Carr, you know, and I was knocking about with them. Lucky Ngā Tuere, one of the most coveted musicians of Wairarapa Gitararua of all time, trained also by the late Red Warren, and great Red Warren, who at one point in his career, his musical career, he was also from Wairarapa Gitararua, Te Matauā Māori, and he was the best guitar player in New Zealand during his time. And being able to mix and mingle with lots and lots of different musicians has always been a great thing. So it's also part of being in the industry. But I mean officially, and actually looking to record and play dates and actually have management that books you into concerts and really managing a good audience and growing that audience and growing your label and all that sort of thing. So I avoided all of that because I didn't have the time to do it. But here I am, e tātou mā with Tahu Posse. And just a couple of things about those two songs. I chose them to start off with because in particular they epitomise some of the things about Bob's music that we don't take enough notice of. But I just wanted to show for those songs the harmony structures in those songs. Very, 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 very professionally done. Technically very, very tricky in terms of structuring up and putting together and when to bring them in. They're very, very well ticked down, those harmony structures, and they work beautifully for the interpretation of the author of those songs. And the other thing was the pace. E tātou mā, they're very close to dancehall dub style pace, quite quick, very near skarsh, yeah, very near ska. So take note of those sorts of things. This is the king of reggae, don't forget. He's not keeping to the rudiments of theory all the time. Though there are some points in time when Bob utilised the rudiments of theory, he did not use them rigidly because he knew reggae a lot better than that. Yeah, he knows reggae a lot better than theory knows reggae. And so he plays reggae exactly how it should be played. So those two songs, yeah, two of his greatest, coming in from the cold off the album Uprising and Rastaman Live Up from off the Confrontation album. I thought I'd note a couple of those tino taonga there within the ways that Bob plays the music. Note those for you, because those are things you should be utilising in your reggae music, whether you like it or not. Reggae music isn't all rudiments of theory. Yeah? It's about understanding and knowing the music so well that you know how to utilise all its other aspects, all its other tenets and precepts that bring out the best in a song. And that's what Bob did. He utilised all of that the best. Kei te ruatakau mā lima meniti mai te whā, tēnei ake e whaiake nei mai I te kīngi ano hoki. War, no more trouble. Mai roto I The Rainbow 1977, taku mōhio, ekene pēr kai te he tēra. Ekene pēr 1979. Kai roto ki te pekitia nei e ki te ake ai, kaiwhia, ai, e tatau mā, kahuri.
Chemist Warehouse has something for that too. For the biggest range and feel-good prices, head to Chemist Warehouse.
Which all permanently discredited and abandoned. Well, everywhere is war. It's your war. And until there's no longer first class nor second class citizens of any nation, until the color of a man's skin is of no more significance to the color of his eyes, I've got to say war. And until the basic human rights are equally guaranteed to all without regard to race, this your war. 'Cause until that day, the dream of lasting peace, world citizenship, and the rule of international morality will remain in but a fleeting illusion to be pursued but never attained. Well, everywhere is war. It's your war. War in the east, war in the west, war up north, war down south. It's a war. Rumors of war. And until the ignoble and unhappy regime that hold our brothers in Angola, in Mozambique, South Africa, yeah, subhuman bondage, yeah, has been toppled, yeah, utterly destroyed. Well, everywhere is war. It's your war. War, war in the east, war in the west, war up north, war down south. It's a war. Rumors of war. And until that day, the African continent will not know peace. We Africans will fight. We find it necessary. We know we shall win. We are confident in your victory. Of good over evil. Of good over evil. Of good over evil. Well, everywhere is we'll be right back.
sinua ta guara tira tira nga pera tanua no yira nga waya ta ro pata tikingi a me ona waya tatsia a kia matang I roto o Tūtahu Trust Tahu Investments Limited ko ngā tino o ngā waiata ti atua I awa waiatana. Ai, te rara no hoki tētahi o te tino I a War No More Trouble o ngā kawe I tērā kawe o ngā waiatara I a War No More Trouble. Tino a tāhua, ne? Tino a tāhua. Yeah, so yeah, they are the favoured renditions to us of those particular songs. That rendition of Coming In From The Cold we had at the start there. The rendition of Rastaman Live Up we had there. And that one's probably the best you'll ever find, apart from the recording itself. And then you get the rendition there of War No More Trouble. We've got No Woman No Cry coming up. Yeah, easily one of the best songs of Te Kīngi of all time. And the rendition of that, one of the favourites. But I just wanted to point out to you, ko iana he ietahi wā kai te whakāroa ke pērā tatau, ia mātou mea hauna e kōrero atu ana I te me te whakāhua ti atu I ietahi, me te wawao atu I ietahi, taku kōrero e takotoa ke ana e tatau mā I rato I ngā kōrero Hawaikirangi. Me taku whakawā atu I ietahi o ngā huatanga e tāma. Koia nā tērā I te mea me taku mōhio atu ki ngā tohungatanga o roto I a mātau a I o roto a nohoki I a tahu posi e tino tau tiaki atu nei roto I a mātau. Tau mana ki atu nei roto I a mātau. And I was just about to get on to some kōrero around that some of the things we will share with you will be more to the levels of what we can expect. Just explaining there a little bit on how I can tend to sound a little bit critical, you know, a little bit of a critique and a little bit judgmental sometimes, but e tata mā, that comes from mastery in the music. In particular, Tūtahu Trust Tahu Investments Limited, we've spent a lot of years, I think from about 2003, bringing through bands and reggae musicians, and some of our reggae musicians are now playing in the States. Some are in the UK playing over there. We've brought through a lot of budding musicians, and they've gone on to study and really take their craft seriously. And now they're budding music, you know, they're basically stars in distant lands. Well, that's only because of our mastery of the music. That's why I speak like that. I'm not really a judgmental critique or anything like that. The show was built for that. Hawaikirangi. So sometimes I will do that just to show that, and sometimes share some of that tohungatanga, but we won't share beyond what we plan to share, because we don't want to give out too much actually ruin things for ourselves in the process. Even if we did, you know, before even doing things like that and sharing our music out there, some of the actual musicians out there, a lot of them got quite, we've had some envy of our mastery in the music. A lot of people talk about the voice work. and all that sort of thing of tahu posi, and also the voice work of our bands in the past, and that coupled with our mastery of the music is just, you know, it's been the talk of the envious for years now around our regions, and so to try and prevent that also. We are holding back a lot of the mastery of the music, but just sharing in those things. Take note, e tāma, of the different uses of the several rhythms, even in those two songs that the king used. And notice how he swapped from one to the other at different times. Rolling along with different moments and songs, different areas of songs that chop and change and hit and all that sort of thing can cause you to move in a certain way with the music. And Bob, yeah, utilised that better than anyone else I know. And he moved with that sort of mastery of the music. You notice the rocksteady rhythms coming thick and hard, and then sometimes you hear the pure coming in more so there, and then right through it's got pure all the way through. But you don't get to hear that so much because over the top you're getting these mixes of different shades and colours of rocksteady rhythms in there. Awesome, eh? Awesome, eh? If you can master things like that. Yeah, no other way to explain those sorts of taonga that Bob used except through the movements of the song, yeah? And moments, yeah? He utilised the music to better embellish those areas and move with those areas and move with the song and make it more emphasised in those different areas. Awesome, eh? Awesome, eh? Notice the pace as well. Wasn't rudiments of theory? No. It was probably in between dance hall and rudiments of theory, right smack in the middle there. And very, very well done, especially for songs like that. War and No More Trouble are songs of, you know, paramount. The messages in those songs are paramount, you know. They're the messages you really want to hear in the world. Because there's so much trouble in the world, and Bob even sung about that. And when he focuses on things like that, and like what he focuses on in No More Trouble and in War, hey, e tātou mā, you get the feeling that, there's no other more priority kaupapa than either of those. And so his mastery of those songs, the moments, the different switches on hits and off hits and the different uses of the rhythms right through. You know, he basically chopped and changed right through both those songs. He did not use the same type of rhythm. And also the same, sometimes he used the same rhythm, but he changed the sound of it. Yeah? Ah, tāhu, eh? You know, and it just makes his reggae so much more beautiful. And once you know how to use taonga like that, you're home and hose. Nirai tātou. And so, kai te tekau mā waru mēniti ki te rima e tātou mā, here we have, tēnei ake anō. A no woman, no cry, e haere tonu ake nā kia tātou kahuri.
don't shed no tears. No, no woman,
no.
One man, no cry.
Tērā o ngā waiata ti atu a rōpata I A No Woman No Cry. Tino, tino a tāhua. Ai rā, me tana whai atu I roto I tērā wā I ngā huatanga ki tērā mea o te Miki, ngā rudiments of theory e kōrero hi ake anana. Ai, ai. And so, yeah, coming to a close for the first show here of the examination of the work of Bob, his work, and some of the tohungatanga. We're not professing to give all, and we're not professing to know all. People like Ziggy Marley would probably help you out there. Probably not, actually. The whole of the Marley whānau would keep that pretty well tight and secret, and probably, yeah, is the main reason why we wouldn't give too much away either. Just a lot more of the obvious. But yeah, envy, I'm not lying about that. I'm not lying about that. We've had some crazy silly things go down, you know, whilst jamming our reggae about, and you know, having a lot of mastery of the music comes with a price. You know, and some people they steal this and steal that, and some people, you know, you always get a lot of people trying to take your thunder sometimes. And although it doesn't worry me, and I never had a chance until now to work into the industry properly, so now that I'm taking it, I've pretty much got control of my own thunder these days, and so it's all cool. But one thing about being critical, te whakawāki atu o etahi, you know, you've got to make sure that you've got your facts together, you've got to make sure you're right, and so those are the reasons why I do say make some of the judgments and say some of the things I say. But not only that, but I'm also well known in the industry, and I also know a lot of, you know, I've got contact with all of the best of them in the country, in the industry, and through one of the main people that I had lots to do with in the past. I haven't seen him much of late, but Manny Abraham is one of the greats of all time. I think he started the band Mana, and so some of his songs there, like Ain't Gonna Stop, whoa, 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 and I ain't gonna stop, you know, all those songs. And yeah, there's a few others I liked of Manny Abraham's, but yeah, a great man to work with and record with, and also just to know, and to have all the contacts you do in the industry. So not many have, you know, and not many will want to come back at us, because pretty much they'll like my judgments, a lot of those guys, because it'll make them pick up their game and make them work harder at their craft. And also that were well known. I mean, I've knocked about with Hallelujah Abraham and Rania Abraham, and also, you know, He Whanaunga Rātou. The same with Manny Abraham as well. And then you've got South Side of Bombay there. And you know what? I thought we were in for some jealousy tahu posse early in January, late in December, when Catch a Fire started to try and say on in one of their posts on Facebook that they were he tū ākana no rātau i roto i te ao puoro. And I just we just had to complain against that. We thought, oh no, here we go, some envy. We were looking out for all of that sort of thing, and but luckily Catch a Fire has backed off on all those sorts of claims, because they're totally untrue. We spoke about it to Te Karere and put that complaint through officially, and made sure. They've backed off and taken the post off as well, because they harai te tuakana Catch a Fire ko mātau I te motu I roto I tētahi o ngā hapu unetārewa tuakana I te motu, and also you know, I te ao puoro, there are people still in the industry that have been in the industry a lot longer than Catch a Fire. And also, it doesn't really matter what point in time you got into the industry, that would just make you a first in the industry, or before, you know, beforehand in the industry, someone who got in there beforehand in the industry. That to us is called whaitomua. That is not called tūākana. There would be an incorrect use of the word tūākana in there. That would be called a whaitomua. And so, ai, kuna nā ngā kōreo I roto I tēnei rā, I a tātou, mātou. E tātou mā. Tātou kua huri ake mai nā, ki roto ki ngā kōreo Hawaikirangi I tēnei rā. Kua tata pau atu, ngā mēneti kia tātou. Kei roto kei tēnei wā, kia wehi atu ki te rungarawa e pā, te iāwe atu a, whakamoe miti, ai te ingoa te iehua. A piti ono ka tā taihono, te mate ki te mate, te ora ki te ora, tātou te kanu hi ora, tēnā rā tātou, kei te mihi atu, ka huri.